What's up, Jeff?
What's going on, Tarek?
How are you?
Man, we've got some trash here, huh?
Yeah, it's a trust sale. You can tell it's been left abandoned for a while.
Yikes.
Oh my gosh.
Jeez.
What is up with the floor?
Yeah, the house kind of feels like it's at a slant, right?
It is. Wow, look at the crack right there. Look at this crack.
Wow.
Oh. Definitely have some issues with the foundation.
Let's go look at the back of the house. Oh, it smells so bad.
No.
Look at this note. Please use the trash can instead of throwing it in the corner.
What? Well, based on the way it looks, they were throwing their trash everywhere.
It reeks of urine.
Okay.
But throw up.
Full gut.
Okay, Jeff, you can look in here, full gut, $2,000.
Oh, man, it does smell in here.
Oh, the good thing is there's only one bathroom.
This is horrible.
It's nasty, you know.
Okay, worse. This is a really big yard.
But it's a complete disaster. Look at this.
There's junk everywhere.
Fence is falling over here.
Do you notice the garage has a giant hole in it? Apparently someone didn't believe in trash cans. Someone...
Hey.
This is all your yard.
There's no way.
Wow.
Oh my God. This is all completely unused right now.
Right, remember when we were driving up, we saw apartments everywhere and complexes?
Oh my.
I mean, honestly, this would be a gold mine if we could build something like that on this lot.
You're talking about a huge score.
Let's make sure that the city's gonna be okay with the zoning first.
After some back and forth, we finally got the house for $272,000. If we can turn this into a multi-unit property, it'll pay off big time. Our contractor, Jeff, has been to the city permit office, and we're meeting him now to find out what they said.
Hey, what's going on, Tarek?
What's up, man? How's it going?
Good, how are you guys?
Good, you guys are working already, huh?
Yeah, getting started on this thing. So
tell me, what is the news with the city?
You can build a multiple unit on here, but if you want to build, you guys have to occupy the property in order to rent out the other part.
Wait, so because we're investors and not owner-occupants, we can't build?
We cannot build.
Do you want to move here?
No.
Wow.
Like that's out.
So now we have another issue. We got the foundation people out here. It's worse than what you guys originally thought.
What?
The foundation is sinking to the front, to the side, and in the rear also. This is some major work. Your whole house has to be brought up.
So not only did we lose the whole back house that we plan on building, but now the whole house has to be lifted back up and put back together?
How much is that gonna cost?
$20,000.
$20,000?
What?
What are the comps on a house this size?
It doesn't even matter. $20,000 for the foundation, that was half of our initial rehab budget. So we're looking at a $65,000 renovation?
$65,000.
Great, our budget just went up nearly 50%.
Nasty. Oh my God, look at those ants. You see those ants? Honey, can you come here? How do you feel about removing this wall right here so it's all open?
Yeah, definitely a good idea.
All right, perfect. Let's do it.
We're way over budget on this flip, and we need to sell it for top dollar. It's a small house, so maximizing the floor plan wherever we can will help out a lot. Sometimes you have to spend it to make it.
The costs keep piling up. Once we got the kitchen gutted, we found water damage. So we're replacing the subfloor, then we can fix the foundation. The reason the foundation is so expensive is because they have to hydraulically lift the entire house and place it on metal support piers that drill 15 feet into the ground. With the house level, the cracks should eventually close up.
Someone in the kitchen could actually still entertain someone over here in the dining room.
Right.
Okay, so let's start with the flooring first, yeah?
Yes. Small house. Right away, I think lighter planks.
Okay, do you like this white one here, or do you like a little more modern one?
I'm thinking the whitewash looks really cool.
The cream color cabinet's out. I only like the dark, dark espresso one on the right, and then the white shaker.
To be totally honest with you, this is probably one of the smallest kitchens that we've ever had to work with. And because of that, I would say 100% the white shaker.
Okay, so definitely not the dark.
It's too dark, it's too small in here. Let's go white and light.
Okay, so here's a question then. For a countertop, we probably want to do quartz here, not granite.
Definitely granite will not go with that combination.
Great, do you want to do a white quartz or a gray quartz?
White.
It's gonna be a small house, but it's gonna be really nice. I just hope we don't lose money after the foundation thing.
Originally, we thought we'd build something back here. Now we can't, so we have to do something out here or else no one's gonna wanna buy it.
Okay, fine, so we can't leave it dirt because buyers aren't gonna like the house, but we can't, you know, remodel the entire yard because it would cost a fortune. So why don't we meet in the middle? What if we just added irrigation and put sod from the back of the house to the back of the garage? Maybe right here we could put up a white picket fence or a little fence with a gate so people know that it's part of the yard and do some flowers right in front of it. We're saving a lot of money. It's still gonna look nice and gives the buyers options, right?
Who knows, maybe somebody will want a pool back here. Yeah, it's a huge area.
I mean, it's still a huge yard. And then back here, obviously it's a huge yard too. What we can do is just grade everything so it just looks like smooth dirt.
Tarek actually has a good idea. Only landscaping half of this yard will save thousands of dollars. And the separate back area will show buyers there's a whole nother lot they can build something on.
We need to figure out a list price. We paid $272, put over $100,000 into it. I mean, nightmare. Foundation killed us. And after closing costs, our break even is about $400,000, and the highest comp is at $389,000.
Oh my gosh.
This is a tough one.
It's awful.
No matter what, we're not gonna make money. The question is, how much money are we gonna lose? I say we come in at $399,900, which is pretty much our break even, and just try to sell it quick and move on. I mean, we need to get out of this house.
At this point, just list it, get rid of it, move on.
With a high comp at $389,900, we're taking a risk, but we have to try and at least make most of our money back. Now we just have to get the house staged and put it on the market.
Now that is a transformation.
Yes, it is.
I mean, there's nothing fancy here. I think it's very simplified, but I think it really works. Yeah, look at those floors.
Beautiful. I love the pop of orange. It looks perfect with the flooring.
I think opening up this wall makes a huge difference because now it shows how much space there is. I mean, there really is space. You have a dining room, a living room. You can even have an eating kitchen.
I'm so glad we went with the all white look here. It makes it feel so much bigger.
I mean, even back here, it just looks so nice. And then for kids, I mean, there's still a huge grass yard.
Someone could buy this house and decide they want to do a little guest house back there, a pool, swing set, whatever.
All right.
That has nice curb appeal. I like the color of the paint.
Yeah. The yard's cute.
Oh my gosh, look at this room.
Beautiful.
It's been completely remodeled. Love for you guys to take a look around and let us know what you think about the design and the price.
Okay. Wow, they did a nice job on the kitchen.
It's got a lot of counter space.
The tile that they chose, it makes it look clean.
Wow.
Cute yard.
They just finished the fence too.
Oh my gosh, it goes all the way back there too. You could have another house back there.
For Orange County, this is a big piece of property right here. Well, the bathroom looks nice. I love the way they tile this.
I love the dark floor. It's beautiful.
They tied in the same counter as in the kitchen. It's small, but I mean, there's room in here.
Oh, this is a big size master. It is a nice size house for a starter home or for a married couple, and you make the other bedroom into an office.
Well, they like the upgrades, but I think the price is a little bit high.
The best we can ask for is at least to get an offer, and that way we can try to negotiate and get the price higher.
After over a month on the market, we finally received a full price offer of $400,000. The buyer, however, requested we pay their closing costs. And with no other action on the property, we accepted. So, after spending over $100,000 on the renovation and an additional 10 grand towards the buyer's closing costs, we have a loss of $3,300. Hopefully, our next house won't be a flop.